Ben Stark here, recording a draft video for channelfireball.com. We're doing an Amonkhet competitive draft league, and this is pack one. Pretty weak pack. Lay Claim is good, but I don't think it's great. Honored Crop Captain is good, but it's a double color card, and it's not splashable at all. Avon Initiate is solid. Cartouche of Ambition is solid. Pretty weak pack overall. So I guess our only real choices are Cartouche of Ambition, Lay Claim, the Honor Captain. True Art Twins is okay. I'm really not a big fan. I mean, I'll play it, of course, but I don't think it's great. I think in this pack, we probably want the Cartouche. It's a card I was undervaluing a little bit at the start of the format. Shoutouts to Reed from that team draft I covered. You know, I think Cartouche is probably a little bit better than I was originally giving credit. Could be Lay Claim. It's probably a pretty close pick. I'm really not a big fan of that card, or blue in general. I'll play blue if it's there, but, you know, for seven, I like to get something like Cruel Reality, not just steal a creature. It's nice that it cycles, but this isn't really a format where you just want to be spending two to cycle all the time. Cycling in this format is, like, something you do because you need lands, not something you should be doing with a card, like, 75% of the time. So I think at 7 mana steal a creature, or, you know, most of the time you just pay 2 and cycle because you're not going to have that many lands, then it's not a very good card. For 7 mana, I want to be winning the game, not necessarily stealing one creature. That said, I would, of course, always play the card. I just don't think it's great. So this pack, Deemworthy is really good. It's definitely the best card in the pack. But, of course, there's also a Trial of Ambition, and we did just start with a Cartouche. There's an Electrify, so there's 2 good red cards. There's 2 good black cards in this pack with Trial of Ambition and Cartouche. So this is another tough pick. I would definitely, and Unwavering Initiate's pretty good too. I would definitely take Deemworthy over any of these on power level. Yeah, I'm just going to take Deemworthy. It's too early to, I think, taking another black card just to have one color of cards. And to be honest, staying on color for Cartouche of Ambition is not very effective because it's just not even that good of a card. Deemworthy is a lot better, I think, than the Black Trial or Cartouche of Ambition. You know, for 5 mana instant, you kill any creature. And I mean, if you get to cycle it and take out a creature, then that's really strong. And the creatures are actually not that big in this format. If you look at a lot of the best common creatures, like Gustwalker or Hooded Brawler, you know, they die to Deemworthy, to the cycle, not to the hard cast. So I think Deemworthy is a pretty effective card. Okay, Harsh Mentor, just an okay bear with a little upside. Shifet Monitor, kind of a big creature with a little upside. Bitterblade Warriors, a solid 2-drop. So this is a pretty weak pack, too. So this is an interesting draft. I mean, don't get me wrong, Deemworthy is not a weak second pick. Our first and our third pick are going to be a little bit weak. None of these are really calling out to me. I think maybe the Shifet Monitor, at least we'll be able to splash the Deemworthy or the Cartouche should we want to. I don't really like to go into drafts thinking, like, oh, I'm going to splash, I'm going to play 3 colors. But given Deemworthy is very splashable and very good, and that was such a weak pack. Like, if there was a Hooded Brawler, I would have snapped up the Hooded Brawler. I would never look at a Shifet Monitor to be able to splash overtaking a Hooded Brawler pick 3 of this draft. But really, I don't even know what the best card in that pack was. Maybe, like, the Bitterblade Warrior? It's a really bad pack. So here we are going to stay on that plan and draft this Evolving Wilds. I promise we're going to put together a normal deck. This isn't a team draft, but, you know, that's what these packs have. And, you know, there's nothing in this pack either. I mean, if you look at this pack, there's virtually no playables. I don't really like Naga Vitalist. I mean, you know, it's okay in a ramp-style deck, which most green decks aren't, although ours is looking like it might be. There's practically not even another playable in this whole pack. There's, like, just some okay cyclers. So now we'll be able to splash something, and hopefully we'll get back to drafting some combination of these colors. Well, another pretty weak pack. The best cards are Cartouche of Solidarity and Pathmaker Initiate. Haze of Pollen is actually okay. The biggest problem with Fog is that it doesn't do anything a lot of the time. You know, it's not an effective card. But, like, when it counters tricks or when you're in a real racing situation, it can be really good. So when you give cycling to it, it doesn't go from bad to good, but it goes from bad to playable. That said, of course, here, we're just going to take the Pathmaker Initiate. It goes with our best card, which is red. white cartouche is fine, but we haven't really seen much white, and I don't consider that a reason to go into white here. Okay, and we're rewarded a little bit. The best card in this pack is definitely Entangler. It's not amazing, but it's a good 2-drop, and helps solidify us in red, and there's not really much to even consider. Wandering Death is a solid card. Essence Scatter is a solid card. But this is a really clear, really easy pick for us. Okay, so now we have a choice. You know, at this point we have 3 red cards. We're set up to be able to splash if we wanted to, especially if we go green-red. The best card in this pack is blue, for sure. Avid Initiate and Labyrinth Guardian are pretty close. I think I like the Guardian, but they're a lot better than Naga Vitalist. Especially, our deck has gotten, like, kind of aggressive. If we were going to draft, like, a ramp deck, I could see the Vitalist being good with the Monitor and Splashing. But really, we just have 2 aggressive red cards and red removal spell now. So I think we'll take the Guardian and see if we end up seeing blue. We probably just won't play it, but you never know. So now there's Manglehorn, which is solid. I mean, people have some artifacts, not a ton. And Seeker, which is a blue common I like a lot. It's not particularly great in our deck right now, but it definitely has the potential to be very good, and it's still pretty early in the draft. So I think this is a pretty clear Seeker. It wouldn't be wrong to take Manglehorn, but I haven't felt like we've seen a lot of green. And it does look like we're seeing blue, so let's go with the Seeker. Okay, now this pack has Desert Ceridon and the Illumination, Compelling Argument, which is not something I would ever take over Illumination. If you're going to have a 1-mana Cycler, you might as well have one that actually does something if you have excess mana. So I think this is a good shot to just take Illumination. Desert Ceridon has just moved down and down and down for me. I mean, a 6-mana 6-4 is just not effective. I love the fact that it's 1-mana cycling, but if you're just cycling it, that's not really helping you. And if you're casting it for 6, like, that's better in the late game than cycling it, but a 6-mana 6-4 is just a really ineffective card. That creature really needs to have First Strike or something like that. I think it's just honestly kind of a poor design. If you wanted to have a red common cycling creature that's playable in Limited, which that card is playable, but it's bad, you should have just given that thing First Strike or something. It doesn't need to be massive, but it needs a little more than it has. So no red-blue cards for us here. We could still end up green, so we'll take that. This ornery... I can't pronounce words. But Kudu. It's not a good card, but it's a solid playable. And, you know, there's still a decent shot we'll be green. Now there's another one in Tormenting Voice. I don't really like Tormenting Voice very much. It's okay with Seeker, you know, if you get Drakehaven or something. Even though red is our most likely color, we could still very easily end up green, and I don't think we're going to miss a Tormenting Voice. And now we close out this pack with just playables on color that we're seeing. Doesn't really matter. These cards don't really matter. So we have 3 colors to choose from. I mean, if we end up with multiple trials or something, we could splash the black cartouche, but probably not going to splash for just that. You know, if this is how splashing works. Like, when somebody is splashing draft after draft, they're doing something wrong because they're taking splash cards too high. Like, let's say we open this pack, and there's a Nefcrop Entangler and a Final Reward. I'm going to take the Nefcrop Entangler. I'm not going to take Final Reward because I have an Evolving Wilds and I can splash. Let's say, on the other hand, there is no Nefcrop Entangler, and there's a Final Reward, and there's basically no red or blue cards. Then I'll take Final Reward, and then I'll splash Final Reward and Black Cartouche because I didn't really have a choice. It was get something barely or not even playable, or get this, like, solid removal spell, and I have an Evolving Wilds. So that's the thing with splashing. It's like you don't really want to do it, and you want to try and avoid it, but sometimes it's correct because you just weren't able to get good cards out of some of the packs otherwise. Okay, so now there's a white Monument, Oketra's Monument, which I like in any deck, but I don't really like to first pick in red-blue decks. There's just great black cards, but we saw no black last pack, and Never Return is great, but it's not splashable. Bone Picker is more splashable, not as great, though still very nice. I really feel like we're more likely to end up red-blue than green, but there's really, like, no playable red or blue cards in this pack, so... And the green cards aren't even good either, so this, I think we're just going to take this white Monument. I mean, as long as we end up not creature light, we'll play it. It's not a great card in our deck, I don't think. That pack was just really, really bad. We've seen a lot of weak packs in this draft. I really hope the other people aren't getting too much. Okay, so this pack's a little better. Warfire Javeliner is great if you get enough spells. Emberhorn Minotaur is very good all the time. Cartouche of Strength is the best card in the pack, in my opinion. But like I said, I don't know if we're going to be green. We did pick up those green cards really late. The problem is they're not very good. So the people passing us could still be green and just not taking those kudus. I don't know how that's pronounced. So I still feel like we should be drafting red and not green, basically. I mean, we got a 6-pick Crop Entangler. That pack probably had more good red cards for us to get a card that good that late. But still, you know, there can only be so many red players to our right if we're getting a 6-pick Crop Entangler. So let's take the Minotaur. It's not that much worse than Cartouche. I don't want to gamble on the Javelinaire here. We don't really have a ton of spells. Even though I will prioritize spells a little bit, given we have the Seeker, I just think that the Minotaur is very solid, and I think we're probably going to draft a pretty aggressive deck. So now there's a 3-drop, and we could actually use 3-drops. We don't really have any. Not sure which one I actually like better, the Sentinels or the Sure Shot. I mean, we are going to have a few cycling cards in red-blue, and the Sure Shot's nice. I mean, it has reach and fire breathing, sort of. Pay 2 mana. Stir the Sands is the best card in this pack, but I'm pretty much not trying to go black, as I just talked about. I'm not going to draft it just because I can splash it. So I think Sure Shot's probably the pick here. It's the best card of our colors in the pack. Okay, and now we have a choice between Avid Initiate and Cartouche of Knowledge. And the more aggressive your deck is, the more you want the Cartouche. Our deck is pretty aggressive. I could see taking either one. I think this feels like a close pick to me. Avid Initiate is really nice. I mean, you know, put it out there, trade it off if you need to, and it can come back. It's a good aggressive flyer. You know, it has good stats. I don't like that it dies to Magma Spray and Splendid Agony, but it's still a reasonable card. We have five. Well, that's not really a 2-drop, and we can't put a spell. We can't put a Cartouche on our Labyrinth Guardian, so we really only have like 3 2-drops, and they're not even that cartoucheable. Or that exciting 2-cartouche. I think Avid Initiate is probably the right pick here. It's just a good body. It's going to help our aggressive plan. You know, play a 2-drop and then follow it up with a nice aggressive flyer. Along those same lines, Floodwaters is good in a deck like this. I know I'm letting Slitherblade go. That might pain some people. I mean, look, I'm not anti-Slitherblade. I don't think that deck is broken. I do think it's playable. But the way our deck is shaping up right now, I mean, I think Floodwaters is going to be castable. We can cycle it, and I think it's just going to be a good card in our deck. I think we're going to be ahead a lot, and then we're going to have to close through some better stuff. So I think Floodwaters is definitely a card we want to end up getting one or two of in this deck. But we're not going to get two of it this pick. I really like Essence Scatter. And don't be fooled. Some types of counters are controlling cards. Essence Scatter is just a good limited card. It's very easy to cast. It's cheap. It trades up. It fills out your curve very nicely. If you have a 2-drop, you don't leave up Essence Scatter. You play your 2-drop. If you have a 3-drop, you don't leave up Essence Scatter. You play your 3-drop. Whatever turn you don't have a drop, or if you're really far ahead, then you leave up Essence Scatter. And limited revolves around creatures. What are they going to do if they don't play a creature on their turn? So, you know, the key with Essence Scatter is that it's basically great because you can play it any turn and have it trade, like, with their turn. So whatever turn you're missing on your draw, if you have a 2-drop, you play your 2-drop, you play your 3-drop. Oh, I didn't draw a 4-drop, go, Essence Scatter your 4-drop. Or if I didn't draw a 2-drop, go, you play a 2-drop, Essence Scatter your 2-drop. It basically fills out your curve really nicely, and sometimes you even get to double spell, and that's just massive bonus. So now there's second Oketra's Monument and Manticore of the Gauntlet. Now, the monuments are legendary. If you gave me a second Oketra's Monument, I would still play 2, even though we're not white and even though it's legendary. That said, the second one is a lot worse than the first one because sometimes you will draw both. I think a solid creature like Manticore for our low-curve, aggressive red-blue deck is definitely a better pick than second white monument. If I were white, I would probably take second white monument, like if I were white-red or something like that. So we could take Temet and splash it. I wouldn't splash it right now off one Wilds. If we got a second, I'd probably do it. Or we could take Tormenting Voice. It's an okay spell. It's not very exciting. We don't have a ton of synergy. I don't really like it. Compelling Argument, kind of the same thing. You know, I'll be happy that I took Compelling Argument or Tormenting Voice if I go on to get, like, that blue-red uncommon, the 0-4 flyer. It gets bigger for spells in your yard. or if I get Drakehaven or something. But with one Seeker, these cards are not very appealing to me. So I think I'm going to take Temet for the upside. I don't expect to splash it, but you never know how the next pack's going to go. Maybe I just happen to like get two Evolving Wilds because there's not much else in the pack. So I think we'll take Temet, but I don't expect to play it. None of these cards matter for us. Or these, really. Okay, I'll make some people happy and take a Slither Blade. Hey, you never know, right? These cards really just don't matter. So I think our deck is looking okay. We're not playable flooded, but we're not super short. We need to have a good pack three. If we play every card we have laid out, which are all totally fine, we're at 8, 11, 14. So we need to get about 10 cards out of this pack, which is a lot. It's not that hard to do, but it's definitely, we can't be taking picks off, really. If we have to move Hyena pack in, we can, or not go Oracle. I won't be happy about it, but it's not the end of the world. So, Lay Claim or Electrify. Of course, none of the other cards in this pack are close. As I talked about, I don't love Lay Claim. I know some people like it more than me, even some of my teammates. I would definitely play it. If I draft it, it's going in the deck. But I think good efficient removal like Electrify is just better. You just have 4 mana, so much more than 7, and I'm fine with paying 7 for something like Cruel Reality. They have to sack immediately, and then every turn for the rest of the game. And if they try and hold a bunch of creatures in their hand, they take 5, they're just going to lose. How many turns are you going to take 5 before you're dead and not play creatures? But Electrify, but Lay Claim just takes one creature. It's a good card, but sometimes they bounce that creature. Sometimes they kill the Lay Claim. Sometimes they have a counter. Like, I don't know. The counter argument's not good because that can counter anything. But I just think Lay Claim is good, but not great. I think Electrify is probably the better pick. Thresher Lizard, Cartouche of Ambition. Nothing else too exciting. Just a bunch of decent white cards. Don't be fooled by this Mind Sensor. Just because it sees Modern and maybe Legacy play doesn't make it a good limited card. Flash is not that important, so it's basically a Windrake. Take away a toughness, give it Flash. That's pretty close to a wash. So, I mean, it's a playable white card in an aggressive white deck, but it is not a good card. It is not an exciting card. On the other hand, speaking of constructed cards that are exciting, Sensor is quite good. It's not amazing. You know, I would take Electrify. I would take Magma Spray over it. But, you know, it's efficient. It can counter people playing their creatures on curve, and it's never dead. You can just cycle it for one mana. So I think it's a clear pick out of this pack. I think that it's not the best card in the pack. You know, Oketra's Attendant and Gustwalker, I think, are better than Sensor. Charioteer if you're red-green. But Shimmerscale Drake and Seeker of Insight are fine playables in our deck, but not very exciting. There are definitely decks where Seeker of Insight might be better than Sensor, but we don't really have that many spells. We're mostly just looking to attack, bounce some creatures, kill some creatures. We have solid removal, Electrify and Deemworthy and a Floodwaters. So I think that for us, Sensor is just a pretty clear pick here. Okay, Commit Memory, it's a nice card. It's not a broken rare in that sense, but it is an effective magic card. Put their best card 2 down, and then you can shuffle it away if you need to, or, you know, if you've emptied your hand much better than them. Skirmisher is an okay 2 drop. Maybe we'll table it if somebody takes Seeker over it, but I think here this is a pretty clear pick. If we did want to splash the white, it wouldn't be a bad time to pick up Aven Wind Guide, but like I said, I'm not really looking to splash. If this pack just didn't have like these decent blue cards for a deck, I would take the Wind Guide. But they do, so this is an easy pick. Commit Memory, good rare, maybe not broken, but definitely not broken, but definitely a good solid rare. Okay, so this pack has Electrify, and this is just a Windmill Slam. I don't like Illusory Wrappings. I might play it in a more defensive deck. I probably wouldn't even play it in this deck. Zenith Seeker is pretty much unplayable in my opinion. You just can't pay 4 mana for a 2/2 flyer in this day and age. And, I mean, you could board it in against certain types of ground-blocking decks or something, but that just doesn't even really happen in this format. Which reminds me, let me talk about this format for a second. People think it's, like, the most aggressive format. And I think it is aggressive, but I don't think the games end that quick. And here's the thing. Exert creatures are small, and they don't hit that hard, but they're hard to block. So what that really does is not make the game end on turn 5 or 6 very often, but what it does is make low power, high toughness creatures, very ineffective. There are a lot of formats where a control deck could cast a Dune Beetle and it would just block not only 2 drops, but 3 drops. In this format, they're just going to exert their Gustwalker or their Bitterblade Warrior or their Hooded Brawler and attack right past it. So you can play cards like Wander and Death that or card drawing to generate extra value because these exert creatures don't hit that hard. But you can't play low power, high toughness blockers because they can't even block. This pack obviously doesn't have any playables, really. I guess I should have probably took cancel as a sideboard card, but I feel like it was a lot more important to talk about that. I think it's a really important concept. Play cards that generate value. This format is not that fast. Do not play low power, high toughness creatures. They can't block. They're ineffective. Now, we'll return to the draft. Okay, so we can pick up second Floodwaters, which I think I would play both. Winds of Rebuke, which might be okay in our deck. We have a decent amount of creatures, not that much removal. I mean, we're actually pretty evenly split, I guess, because Commit Memories removal, we picked up second Electrify, Sensor, Essence Scatter. I guess we actually don't have that many creatures, so maybe that's not a good idea. We have 8 plus this Monument plus some card drawing. So I guess we'll go with Tormenting Voice as it helps us dig and find our creatures and not one of the bounce spells. Normally I would think Winds was better. I just realized we're actually a little bit creature light. So we need to start prioritizing some creatures. And there's a good one. Happy to take another Raven Initiate. And a Tuckrupt Skirmisher. They're the only cards in our colors in the pack. Now there's not really anything for us, but we'll take the Snog Oracle. Seeker of Insight did table. Wow, and white is being really underdrafted if Oketra's at 10 tables. That's a first pickable white card. It's not a broken white card, but it's a good white card. I think it's maybe slightly worse than Gustwalker, but not a lot. That's not a card that should be tabling. But Seeker for us, of course. Skirmisher for us. Okay, our deck filled out kind of nicely. So I think this one really came together here at the end. Looks like we have enough playables. I don't think this is a Slitherblade deck. I think that, you know, we are aggressive. Cancel, I mean, we're going to have a lot of blue sources. I think we can play the cancel. Our curve is low. There's a Slitherblade in our board. I'll look at it during deck building. But I think to play, here's the thing with the Slitherblade deck, right? You have to play like 14 lands, not 16. Because if you're going to play a deck full of one mana cards, what happens when you draw 6 or 7 lands? You have no deck. So, you know, if you can draft like a mono blue deck or something and have 3 blue cartouches, 6 litter blades, and play, 12 islands or 13 lands, that's probably a wonderful deck, assuming the rest of your cards are cheap and playable. But what happens if you have to play a 2-color deck? You want to play 14 lands, you have to play 7-7. That's not great for an aggro deck. Our mana is going to be good. We have Evolving Wilds. We're probably going to play 16 lands. We'll get like 8 blue, 7 red in the wilds. But I'm just not trying to play a 1-mana 1-2. I just don't think that really does enough for us. But we don't really do anything with cycling, so Compelling Argument does nothing for us. Casting Non-Creatures is good, so maybe we'll play the Bounce Spell. Maybe we'll play the Tormenting Voice to trigger these Seekers. Alright, so that actually looks right to me. Let's take a look at the sideboard, but this is almost certainly, I think, a 16-land deck. Our curve is low, but we're not going to go to 15 with Seekers to loot away extra lands and stuff. I don't want any of these Naga Oracles or Ancient Crabs. I don't think we need the Slither Blade. Also, we don't really have cartouches and stuff. Slither Blade gets better, of course, if you're, you know, enchanting it. It's good with White Trial. Like, you know, if you have a double White Trial 16-land aggro deck, I could see playing Slither Blade a lot more. So I think this deck actually came together pretty well. I think we got pretty lucky in pack 3, but I do think blue was the open color and red. I mean, we got like a 3rd or 4th pick Electrify. I feel like red is being like drafted by the correct amount of drafters at our table, but the people directly to our right are not red because you don't get past Deemworthies and Electrifies from red players. But at the same time, we didn't get a lot of red cards and red's pretty deep. And blue was wide open at this table, of course. I mean, we were tabling good blue cards, getting initiates late, you know, tabling seekers and skirmishers and stuff. So I think we did a good job of finding the open colors here. I think this deck is pretty medium, but I think the packs were pretty bad. So I'm pretty happy with what I've got. Magic Online often suggests a much wider range than I would run. You always need both colors in these 2-color decks. So usually I'm only going to split them one apart, unless you have all these double blue cards. Like if we had double blue 2-drops and double blue 3-drops and 4-drops, then I'd go another island or two. But with 8 in a wild, that's 9 blue sources. Plus we have Tormenting Voice if we draw a double red and not blue to help find it, plus cycling. So since I really want to have an island and a mountain every single game, red is not a splash. I think you pretty much just want one more island. Okay, pretty fun draft. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in round 1.